Hello, in this video, I am going to answer, but doesn't chemotherapy kill me? This is a common comment and question that we get in the comments, so we thought we would respond to that. Before I go on, I'd love to invite you to subscribe to our channel. As you can see, we respond to comments and questions, so if you have a question that isn't answered with one of our videos, we'll make a video, and we appreciate all the suggestions. So this video is in response to several comments we've had about avoid chemotherapy at all costs, it will kill you. The other thing I'd love to do is invite you to go to yerbba.com to get your personalized Yerbba report. So let's talk about chemotherapy and does chemotherapy kill? The short answer is yes, chemotherapy kills cancer cells, if not all of them, many of them. Does chemotherapy kill people? Extremely rarely, and I'll cover that more in a moment. The way chemotherapy works is by killing rapidly dividing cells. And these cancer cells are vulnerable. They're actually really fragile. You know, they make babies and they have progeny. So the mother cell will make baby cells and then they keep making cells after them. But the cell itself is quite fragile. It dies pretty easily, and chemotherapy will kill rapidly dividing cells, especially cancer cells, because they are deranged. Their DNA is so messed up that it's really hard for them to repair. Normal cells, like our hair cells and our mouth and our GI tract and our fingernails, those cells are actually really robust and they can repair after damage from chemotherapy. So normal cells, while they don't always recover, and while some people are left with long-term effects, and while some of those things take a long time to heal, like fatigue and neuropathy, we know our nerve cells regenerate it 1 millimeter a month, but they do regenerate. Cancer cells have a tough time doing that. Now, not all cancer cells are vulnerable to chemotherapy, and that's why we see cancer cells growing even in the face of chemotherapy. And as I'm talking about this, I'm thinking we ought to do a video on cancer resistance to treatment. But let's focus on, does chemotherapy kill? So we have randomized trials with thousands and thousands and thousands of people all over the world where people were randomized to receive chemotherapy versus no chemotherapy. And then as we knew chemotherapy helped, we generally make refinements to the chemotherapy. And what I mean by that is we might combine two drugs that haven't been combined, or we use longer courses of chemotherapy or shorter courses. We don't want to give more than we need to, but we also don't want to shortchange people and give less chemotherapy and prompt resistance to chemotherapy. So we know from trials that chemotherapy is safe and effective. That doesn't mean it's not toxic, but it's safe in terms of survival. And we have early stopping rules. So if people die on chemotherapy on a trial, the trial is stopped. And then we follow people over time for months and years to compare those groups. And we're looking, yes, for toxic deaths, deaths from the chemotherapy, and we're looking from deaths from cancer. When people die and they're receiving chemotherapy and they die, in the vast majority of cases, they die from the underlying cancer. They die because the chemotherapy was not effective enough in killing the cancer cells or keeping the cancer cells from growing back. There are some cancers that are just, for lack of a better word, evil. And they will shrug off chemotherapy, if you will, or spit it out, or laugh it off. That's how I view them. There are some cancers that are so uncontrollable that chemo won't work, and the person receiving chemotherapy will sadly, unfortunately, and tragically die from the cancer. They died while receiving chemotherapy, but not from the chemotherapy.
Diagnosed with breast cancer? Meet Yerbba, your guide to personalized treatment options. Each option is specifically tailored to the unique characteristics of your tumor. Sign up today at yerbba.com to take control of your breast cancer journey.
Now, there are exceptions. There is some chemotherapy that can cause other cancers down the road. The ones in particular that come to mind are people who die from what are called secondary leukemias. As I mentioned, we like to give as much chemo as possible and to make sure that we're helping as many people. But down the road, whether it's a year or two or 10 years later, some people can get enough DNA abnormalities in their, especially in their bone marrow, that they might develop leukemia. And then we have to decide, is this regimen, this chemo recipe, something we can continue using? Because we saw maybe 1 in 300 people die from leukemia. Now, I will tell you, most of my patients who have developed leukemia from cancer treatment for breast cancer, and it's actually only a few people, have said they wouldn't go back in time. They don't regret the years that they got from chemotherapy. They're maybe 5 or 10 years out from a very high-risk breast cancer, and they say to me, I wouldn't do it any differently. I've been given all these years from chemo, and I understand that this might be from the chemotherapy, and I wouldn't go back. I'm hoping this is helpful. Yes, chemotherapy is toxic. None of us want to get chemotherapy, but we are really careful in whom we give chemotherapy because of the risks and benefits, and because we have data from years and years of data. This is why we need people to enroll in clinical trials, and we are so grateful for that. And I am so grateful for your comments, questions, and that you watch this video. We'll see you again next time.